Today, the office of the... Age was once the residence of emperors and presidents. Today, Chapultepec Palace is a museum, a symbol of Mexico's long and passionate history. Between the Zócalo and Chapultepec Palace, Emperor Maximilian built a grand avenue, now known as the Avenida de la Reforma. Not far from the Reforma is one of Mexico's most beautiful buildings, El Palacio de Bellas Artes, the Palace of Fine Arts. Guidebooks describe its elegance, say it is the home of the famous Ballet Folklorico de Mexico, and speak of the great orchestras, concert artists, and singers who have all performed here. And it is all true. I prefer, however, to speak of what I feel, of what is true for me when I see the Bellas Artes. My parents came to Mexico as visitors and love it so much they stay. They were the leading performers of the light opera form known here and in Spain as Zarzuela. And this is where I made my operatic debut. As a boy, my Sundays were spent playing soccer, football, and in the evening watching my parents perform. Later in the cafes in Garibaldi Square was mariachi music. If there was a special girl, and in my case, she became my wife, you hire a mariachi group and serenade her in the small hours with songs like Despierta, dulce amor de mi vida. Despierta. There is another Mexico, of course, a Mexico perhaps more familiar to the world. It is the land that sparkles in the sun, in resorts like Cancun, Ixtapa, Puerto Vallarta, Manzanillo, Los Cabos, and here in the Blue Pacific, is Acapulco. Acapulco is not the world's oldest resort, but it might well be the most famous, because it's not just a place to go, but a place to be, a place where the senses come to life. No one can know Mexico in a lifetime. One can only hope to savor it, to explore it like an idea, to experience it like a deep emotion. Beyond Mexico's beauty, there is something no words can convey, the hospitality of the people. The people invite you, as I do, to come, feel the warmth of Mexico.
Despite the destruction of all this splendid artwork, the Mexicans remain joyful, for they have spent another day in glorious fiesta. There's a thread of beauty that runs through 2,000 years of Mexican history. Embroidery. Threads of exuberant colors enhance all things Mexican. Pansies pop up everywhere. Lace forgets to be prissy. Ribbons go dancing. And silk shawls throw caution to the wind. Embroidery is found everywhere in the region of Oaxaca, a beautiful complement to Mexico's natural resources. Pity the poor tin can. It's about to be put to shame by the skill and imagination of Mexico's tin artists. With clips of a scissor, entire fantasies are created. A tree bursts forth from the earth. A mirror reflects inner happiness. A butterfly becomes a lifelong friend. In the the magic hands of Mexico, tin is yet another way of creating extraordinary beauty. When it comes to the weaving of palm reeds, sometimes the feet of Mexico are as clever as the hands. As the toes tap out an intense and concentrated rhythm, it is almost as if the knowledge of beautiful things to come is what keeps these artists relentlessly involved. Suddenly, as if from nowhere, rainbows of thatched beauty emerge, along with coils of interwoven colors and baskets that are filled with dreams. There is great strength and enormous power in the hands of Mexico. Every ounce of this massive strength must be summoned for the creation of copper artwork. Dragged across huge mounds of fire, the metal must literally be...